Hey, everybody. Welcome to On the Fly. I'm Steve Gelbs. Mike Kelly will join us throughout the show. And it's a show that begins with us asking the question, what the heck is going on right now? I mean, you're always going to have teams that are hot, but this many on this type of a tear all at one time, it's wild. For those keeping score at home, here's what was on the line on Thursday night. The Seattle Kraken had a chance to match a franchise-best 8-game winning streak with a victory over the Capitals. And the Jets can set their franchise record win streak at 8 as well with a win over the Blackhawks. Meanwhile, the Panthers were going for 9 wins in a row, plus they had a chance to jump the Bruins into first place in the Atlantic. And then, of course, you had Connor McDavid's Oilers. Edmonton also chasing their 9th consecutive win, an accomplishment that would tie the club record. Could they do it? That's where we start the show off, the Oilers chasing some history in Motown.
Here's Kane with a shot off the goalpost.
And that looked a lot like the Patrick Kane who has scored 40 twice in his spectacular career.
Bouchard has it knocked away. A stolen puck here by Larkin. Catching up Rasmussen, gives it to him. Back for Larkin. What a play defensively.
When Rasmussen felt the presence of number 97, he thought, I can't shoot this. I got to give it back to Larkin.
Picked up by Kopp. Kopp with room. And a shot. He scores! Slump buster to be had.
Edmonton is challenging that there was goalie interference.
The goalie's on the top of the crease. Fisher, I don't think Fisher
Pickard
even touches
puts
him.
His glove into him.
After video review, it was determined that there was no goaltender
right.
interference.
Wow.
That came dangerously close to too many men. Snatched away, McDavid makes a move. Tucks it home for the equalizer. On a broken play at the blue line, McDavid somehow makes it work, and we are tied.
I mean, this puck just sits for McDavid. There's nobody that can put the Jets on like him and navigate through sticks' bodies. And what a deke around the pad. I mean, he literally just tucks that around the right pad of Lyon.
Down low, McDavid breaks free. Larkin inside, nudge toward the net, the save made. Echo, Richard score! Off a loose puck, Zach Hyman buries it. Edmonton's first lead of the night with 6 minutes to go.
And a big celebration from Zach Hyman here. I mean, they have been all around 40 shots now.
Back to the line, kept in by Larkin for Raymond. Off the bench comes Perron. In front of the goal! Sitting up! No. They score! Anna bangs it in! 2-2 tie!
Kept it in the line, and it's kind of a harmless play. It looks like it goes off the skate of Nurse. Left pad by Pickard that kind of sits behind him. He doesn't know where it is. And nobody picks it up, but Mata, he beats everybody to it with the poke check, finishes it off, and ties this game.
Springs for Draisaitl in front, redirected, a leaping drive, backhand score! Evander Kane!
We got a glove pass, no goal.
So he kind of knocks it down. Is there any contact? No. Wow. I mean, Detroit is catching breaks in this one.
And McDavid will change as well. A handoff to Zach Hyman. Hard to the net! Rolls in front. Turned over, Nurse shoots and scores! This game is over! Darnell Nurse wins it! 3-2 in overtime!
Yeah, a little extra celebration for this one because they dug in deep to win it. And what a flurry of events here in overtime. It's always exciting, and this one was no different.
Yeah, I think, just our ability to stick to it. You know, there was some bounces, they made some good plays, and our team wasn't discouraged at all and found a way to win in the end. I mean, anytime that you can put the wins together, but, you know, win them in a lot of different ways, and I think we tied a franchise record there with wins, and I think we talked about that a little bit before the game, so it was a cool opportunity to do something special, and I think this is a special group, and it's nice to win with.
All right, we now welcome in Mike Kelly for more on this one. The Oilers win their 9th consecutive game, 3rd team in franchise history to do that. What more can we say, though, about Connor McDavid? What else did you see from him tonight besides that ridiculous goal?
Hey, you know, one goal. We've seen him have 4 or 5-point nights. Just 1 point on this night. It's not always about points, though. And the Red Wings can thank Alex Lyon for getting them a point because without him, they would have been blown out in this game. But Connor McDavid had so many looks. He played such a good game. And if it wasn't for Alex Lyon, he probably would have had a couple of points before he ever even got that highlight reel goal. He's setting guys up. He's walking into the house with some good grade A opportunities. He was buzzing all night in this game. And this play right here, he doesn't touch the puck right away. If he had, that's offside. He had the presence of mind to just hold up. Now I got it. And off goes the McDavid show with the crazy stick handling. Another great play here. He didn't get an assist on this play, the centering pass, but puck ends up going out to Zach Hyman, who scores, make it 2-1. His fingerprints were all over this game. And you look at what he did in the game. He had more ozone puck possession than anyone. Double-digit zone entries with possession. He passed more pucks into the slot and shot more pucks from the slot than anybody. Just a real dominant presence in this game was Connor McDavid.
Yeah, and Mike, even though you say it's not all about points during this nine-game winning streak for the Oilers, Connor McDavid, 15 points. He's now got a point in 21 of his last 22 games. So the Oilers get it done with their ninth consecutive win. How about the Panthers? Could they do it? Take it on the Kings.
Love down by Kulikov, but picked up. Laferriere is in. Big save by Bobrovsky. And then batted out of the air wide. Oh, Sergei Bobrovsky, 2 minutes in, coming up huge.
There's the save with the arm, and then you see Bobrovsky with the concentration, the shot off the arm, and look at how he tracks down that puck. He looks over his shoulder, flops over on the other side. Make sure he's covering the majority part of that net.
Cycles it for Fiala. Nice move. In on goal. Went off his stick. He centers in front. Dano can't find it. Still loose. Score! Trevor Moore! The Kings with a great shift from the Dano Fiala Moore line, and Trevor Moore starts the scoring.
Everyone moving, no one standing, changing positions, attacking the net, and making it happen.
18 goals, now a new career high for Trevor.
Trying to get through. Slows to read it on the wing. Puts it in front, deflected, score! Oh, what a play by Sam Bennett! And the Panthers have evened it up.
We talked about Sam Bennett, and he never gave up on this play. Look at, he dishes it off, and now he's going to go right to the front. Moisturinen, and look at this open space right there. And there's Bennett's stick. All right, let her go. Gets it with his stick and his skate.
Kopitar wins the draw. Kings on the power play. Doughty up top with a blast. Score! Drew Doughty lets it go from straight out, 55 feet. It's a power play goal late in period two, and the Kings have regained the lead. They're up 2-1.
Doughty has to have his head up here because it's a one-time shot. You know, early on, you win a face-off, get a shot. Simple, make it happen, win a draw, get it on net.
Great screen there by Andrzej Kopitar as that puck went up high. He got himself directly in front of the goaltender providing the screen.
They scored just 7 seconds into the power play. Eighth of the year for Doughty.
Panthers, 6-on-5, lead in the third. Trying to tie it. It's a chance for Verhaeghe. He scores! Win streak is still alive. It's 2-2 late in the third period.
I think Matthew Tkachuk got the deflection, but as soon as it went onto the stick of Verhaeghe, you knew that he was going to go top cheese. Here it comes across, fires it high, just the heel, and goes in by the glove of Talbot. And the Panthers' heroics continue.
5 seconds left in overtime. Here's Reinhardt on the doorstep of the backhand. He scores!
The Panthers wait until the last second of overtime. A power play goal. And who else? Sam Reinhardt.
He was on the ice for the last 2 minutes and 4 seconds. And he scores with less than a second to go. Incredible.
I don't know. It's been a while since we played in front of these guys. So just try to finish the job off and give them something to cheer about. You know, we knew it wasn't going to be pretty. It was going to take everything. Great one to tie up in the end, and it's nice to get the extra point.
Yeah, it's just that playoff mentality. I mean, they're probably the best defensive team in the league, and it's been a while since we beat those guys, so nice to get one on home ice.
All right, Mike Kelly's back, and man, Sam Reinhardt, he could not have timed this type of a season better, the pending unrestricted free agent. He's got 30 goals now, just 3 away from his career high already. How has he been getting it done on this level this year?
Yeah, he's a master in front of the net. That's where he gets a whole bunch of his goals, and the overtime goal is a great example, but you're right, he's a hat trick away from tying his career high in goals, and there's half a season left. And a lot of them come from right about where he scored this one against the LA Kings in overtime, right in front of the net. His hands in tight are elite. He gets a lot of shots from here, but you also got to be able to do things like this where you can get out far enough to get it over a goalie, get it over a pad, get a rebound over a pad, deflect pucks, all those things that great net front players have to do. And look no further than just the inner slot, that home, or not the home plate, the diamond-shaped area right in front of the net where half the goals in the league get scored every year. It's him and Zach Hyman right at the top of the list. So you go there and you have hands like Sam Reinhart, you're going to score a lot of goals. I don't think he's going to sustain this pace, but he's always going to be a guy with that kind of volume in tight that's going to get a good chunk of goals.
Sam Reinhart, second fastest in Panthers history right now to 30 goals. Unbelievable season so far for Reinhart and for the Panthers. We now head to Pittsburgh and get some highlights from the Canucks and the Penguins.
Dubrovnik gets the puck ahead to Brock Besser. On the left wing, Elias Pettersson steps over the blue line. Nice move to the middle. Pettersson in front. Besser scores! Elias Pettersson with a little dangle inside the blue line and put it on the tape of Brock Besser, who opens the scoring here in Pittsburgh.
This is outstanding awareness by Besser, Miller, and Pettersson. Pettersson makes this awesome move. Guess what? That's on the forward that's back because Letang's behind the net.
Quinn Hughes back for Pettersson, settles the puck, finds Miller. He shoots, he scores. Besser might have tipped that one too. And he's got his second of the game. A power play goal makes it 2-0.
Besser doesn't miss it. Quickly, 6.5 minutes in, two for Besser, two for the Canucks, and a 2-0 lead.
Hands it off to Carter. Stick check. Bouncing puck. Harkins tracks it down. Good work. Back for Pettersson. A shot. Score! Great work from Jansen Harkins, and a finish from Marcus Pettersson. His first of the year as it 2-1 Vancouver.
What a play by Jansen Harkins all around right here. Just a dog on this puck, but then ability under pressure to make the next play.
JT Miller turns, trying to get away from Carlson. Banks one back to Hironik. Philip Hironik, wrist shot tipped in. Elias Pettersson this time. And Pettersson able to redirect the Hironik shot and make it 3-1.
Yeah, just like I said, get through to the end of the period with a one-goal lead. Now it's a two-goal lead. What a start for Pettersson here as the Lotto line clicks again.
New goaltender Alex Nedeljkovic's night is over. 3 goals against on 9 shots. In comes Tristan Jarry. Knocked off his stick. Garland in front. Bluger shot. Gloves. Save. Jarry, look what he's got.
Wow.
Oh, there you go.
And here we go. Sidney Crosby with Raquel. Here comes Crosby. Shot. Score! Sidney Crosby now tied for 22nd all-time in NHL history at 573 goals. Knocked out of his hands. Canucks come in. Myers holding, shooting. Oh! Tristan Jarry putting on a show.
It's about his 7th grade-A save here this period.
Puck is center. Chance for Crosby. Demko the save. And then Crosby put the rebound through the crease and out the other side.
Wrister, the boxer! They score! The Penguins tie it! Crosby was there, and he's pulled Pittsburgh even!
And this time, a massive goal with 28 seconds left, and Crosby has done it again.
Aaron Carlson right wing, centering pass, Hironik broken up. Here go the Canucks the other way. Elias Pettersson in alone, on a breakaway. Pettersson to the forehead, scores! Elias Pettersson wins it for the Canucks, their 4th straight victory. The Lotto line pillages the Penguins, and the Canucks take it 4-3 in Pittsburgh.
4-point night, 4 in a row for the Canucks, and Elias Pettersson, who else gets the game winner?
All right, so Vancouver wins again, and, you know, Elias Pettersson, he becomes the first player, Mike, in NHL history to score the game winner in 4 consecutive road games. And, you know, it's not just about Pettersson, it's about that Lotto line. We just heard they pillaged the Penguins. I love that line. What have you seen from Pettersson, JT Miller, and Brock Besser together?
Yeah, Rick Tocchet hit the jackpot putting those guys back together. It's been 4 games now, and they've been crushing everybody that they play. These guys are scoring a ton of points. Pedersen's got 7 goals. Look at this pass. Look at the awareness on that assist. It's unbelievable. Pedersen, 7 goals in those 4 games. And he's putting on an absolute clinic. He also, in my view, doesn't get enough credit for how good he is defensively. I think he's got Selke candidate defensive game in him. over 16 minutes shorthanded this season that he's played, as well as what he's doing in the power play, what he's doing at even strength. But this Lotto line is just on fire right now and carrying this team to a lot of success. And honestly, like Elias Pettersson, you think about how good the Canucks are, how good he's been this season, you start thinking, well, he's got to be in the Hart Trophy mix, right? Like, his biggest threat might be the other guys on his own team that are going to get some votes, because there's so many, like Quinn Hughes, there's so many good players on that Vancouver Canucks team, but man, he's been a driver lately.
Yeah, that line, you just saw the stats, 9 points against the Penguins in this game combined. They have been a force in these four games they've been put together. A lot of great finishes that we've seen so far. Let's keep it going. Another great game, another fantastic finish, this time in Tampa, Devils and Lightning.
Marking his NHL debut at the age of 22, Gage Gonsalves.
Yeah, this is a young kid.
A lot of mileage there.
There is, and boy, has he been great.
Mercer gets to the front. Vasilevskiy to save. Mercer scores! Stuck home the rebound from the side door, and the Devils lead.
Dawson Mercer sticks with this puck in play and banks it off Vasilevskiy.
Barbix shoots, deflected, and they score. This one's tipped in front, I believe.
It wasn't even going on net.
Chernak takes a hit there from Bastion, and in comes Gonsalves. The rookie came flying in there with his mom, Sydney, and his dad, Fernando, watching on.
How about a start like that for the young man?
First, she couldn't believe that her son ran somebody in his first game, and now she can't believe the call. The power play for the Devils, just like the Lightning is bearing up. Scores! Shot and a goal! And the Lightning have the lead! It's Glenn period. And that is their first shorthanded goal this season. Back to Hagel. Extra attacker is on. Molly Portis Kudrow to the middle. Point! Scores! Brandon Point one time from the slot. 3-1 Tampa Bay.
Great opportunity here for New Jersey. Marino blasts it, deflected. What? Rebound off the put. Posted in! It bounced around and the Devils score! The Devils are back in it.
We said that goal is going to be important, and the relentless shift and the hard work, and they followed it up with another one.
Reported to you during the intermission, no Eric Chernak for the rest of the night, suffering an upper body injury earlier this evening, back in the first period.
Nate Bastian with a takeaway. He breaks in. He scores! In his 200th career game, Bastian ties it.
This is just terrific work by the Devils, and good to see Nate Bastian get rewarded. We're tied at three. Big goal, second of the season for Nate Bastian.
How about the play there on the intercept? He used his skate. Gets the handle, feeds the point. Brendan Smith uncorks it. Vasilevskiy to save. Rebound's not covered yet. And the Cloud scores! And the Devils lead!
Okay, so they're challenging for offside. So it looked like Nemeth brought it back in, so that would make it offside. I think they're going to get off the hook here.
Play was offside. We have no goal.
Fans in attendance like the decision, and it is still a 3-3 game.
And both teams will happily secure that first point to head toward overtime.
Got to cut in. Kudrow with the backhand. Pulls it back. Still with it. Gets it around us. His shot. Score! Back-to-back overtime goals from defensemen. And another big 2 points in the bank for the Lightning.
So the Lightning strike at home once again. They've won 7 of their last 9 games at Amalie Arena while scoring over 3 goals per game. And the PK has been great as well. They held Jersey goalless on their only power play opportunity on Thursday. Meanwhile, some tough injury news out of Anaheim on Thursday. Trevor Zegras needs surgery to repair a broken ankle. He's going to be out for the next 6 to 8 weeks. Also, rookie defenseman Pavel Michikov, he will be out approximately 6 weeks with a separated shoulder. Both players were injured Tuesday in Nashville. As for the rest of the Ducks, they were back in action on Thursday night visiting the Hurricanes.
Svechnikov brings it back in for Aho, and a big save by Gibson. Back in front of Gibson with a 10-bell stop.
Into the Ducks zone where Stahl will get to it first. He'll take a big drop and back, and the score! Oh, what a beautiful setup from Seth Jarvis to Brady Shea, who makes no mistake.
That is a beautiful tic-tac-toe goal.
Hayes now want to add a little bit more as Carolina spins it across, and a tic-tac-toe.
The Carolina zone is turned around by Chatfield, trailing the play. It's dug out, and Leeson gets it in front for Lundestrom, who scored.
Jordan Martinook there, who's playing in his 600th game, will feed Jarvis. Jarvis back to Martinook. He scores! Oh, what a beauty! In his 600th game, Jordan Martinook puts Carolina back up by two. It's 3-1.
Here's tremendous sauce.
Ducks recover in the corner. Stop move by Terry. Now from the bottom of the circle again. There's Svechnikov. He pops it across, and they score. Gudas came down low, and they get another bounce.
And right on the power play, they score. Frank Vetrano.
What a season for Vetrano so far, and he just snaps this off the inside of the bar.
Comes the killer through the job. Munson coming into the backhand. Kochetkov's run into. Puck's loose. Kochetkov is down in the crease.
You're trying to score. He's trying to avoid the goaltender. He gets nudged. It looks like Kochetkov is going to leave this hockey game. This is major development.
Antti Raanta comes in, a 34-year-old netminder. The Storm is went to front of the net. Back in, Jason scores! Stefan Nason!
And that's a huge goal for Nason. Well, that's a tough hit right there, baby.
And now, ready to drop the gloves. We're going to get the whistle here. The red line is going to go with Sam Carey.
Big shoulder from Lemieux. There is surprise there.
10 seconds left on the power play. Shea with it. He'll hand it off. Terrifying inside of the net. And the score! Jack Drury! Another tic-tac-toe! Martinook will get to it. He'll play it back to Burns. Burns loads up! Score!
What an evening Jarvis has had. We're going to hope that it's not significant to Kochetkov. I can tell you, Raanta, historically as a Hurricane, has played some very fine games.
And the horn sounds. Carolina wins it tonight, 6-3.
Auston Matthews keeps moving up the Leafs' all-time goals list. Another multi-goal effort gave Toronto to lead, but this one needed overtime. Highlights next.
The Islanders have shuffled all four lines. Casey Cizikas injured on Tuesday, so he's out. He's week to week, and because of that, Matt Barzal goes from the wing back to center.
We'll see how these lines shake out.
It'll set up the Islanders on the man advantage.
Dotson got it on net! Palmieri scores! And 40 seconds in, the Islanders grab the lead at home.
And then, you know what? Sometimes when you don't have anything, you put the puck on net. Great job by Palmieri to gobble up that rebound off the Dobson shot.
Dobson quarterbacking that top power play unit for the Islanders, which, as you said, much improved. Dobson fifth among NHL defensemen in points this year. Nice, got leveled by Mayfield up along the wall.
He's carrying the puck in, and then it's a big hit by Mayfield.
Throwing. Or Gregor slides it across. Score! Bobby McMahon slams it home for his second of the year, and the Leafs have tied the game at one.
That is some kind of motion in the offensive zone from the fourth line. And Gregor, who's a shooter by nature, flips it over to McMahon beautifully for a one-timer to tie the game.
As Marner counters it up, throws it back in front for Matthews, scores!
How's your patience? Oh my goodness!
That's the best goal scorer in the league, going to work.
18 goals in his last 17 games, now one behind Ron Ellis for fourth on Leafs' all-time goal-scoring list. Harass stolen by Matthews, walks in and shoots, scores! A Dobson giveaway winds up in the back of the net, and Auston Matthews has done it.
And that is not the player to turn the puck over to.
He's tied Ron Ellis for fourth on the Leafs' all-time goal-scoring list.
For Barzal, he surveys, drops for Romanov. Speeding in, he scores! Oh, what a sight from Alex Romanov!
Good creativity, keeping it outside, but then for Romanov, what a snipe! Who knew he had that? And that is a great shot. Far side tucks it right inside the post.
He scans. Barzal back for Dobson. Loading it up!
A little nifty backhand pass creates a better angle. Watch Barzal pull it to his backhand, and he gets a better passing angle back to Noah Dobson, who has all the time in the world to rip that wrist shot off.
Engvall winds his way back in, drops it back to Nelson. He's across the Pashik with a shot, and Martin Jones comes across and makes the save. Jones way out to play with Pashik, who steals it and shoots that wide.
And we will have overtime on Long Island.
Islanders win the faceoff. Dobson to the net, front for Barzal. Shoot! He scores! Matt Barzal with his fourth point of the night,
get great wood on it, so I was just waiting for it to trickle in, and it finally did. So it's a big win for us. We had two tough games the last two, so to get this one tonight against a good team is a big one. Down 3-1, power play got a big one there with Bo, great tip. Just no quit. We knew this was a big game. You know, coach shook the lines up this morning, so we knew we had to come to play, and we did.
Back with Mike Kelly now. And Mike, the Islanders score the game's final three goals, win 4-3 in OT. Just how impressive has Noah Dobson looked to you? Do you think this guy's got a Norris Trophy potentially in his future?
Yeah, I think that's absolutely a fair comment. If he's not in the conversation this year, that's an oversight. I wouldn't have him as a favorite this year, but he's absolutely in the conversation, which is a great compliment to give him. 4 points in the game. Like, Matt Barzal had four as well. Let's give him some love. But Noah Dobson shoots the puck a ton. He's good at getting pucks through. That's how the Islanders get their first goal. This is how the Islanders like to create a lot of their offense, is shoot for tips, deflections, rebounds, score that way. He's a guy taking a lot of these shots. And the vision on this pass here, to put it right on the stick of Barzal to chip it home, it is tremendous. He's having such a good season. So I absolutely expect that he's in a lot of people's Norris thoughts right now. You look at where he ranks top 10 in the league in a bunch of key areas, shot attempts, passes into the slot, beating guys one-on-one in open ice, recovering pucks with his skating ability, and top five in points per game now among defensemen at over a point a game. This is outstanding stuff from Noah Dobson, who's kicked it up a gear, which is especially important when you consider some of the injuries that they've had to battle through.
Yep, the four assists on Thursday night, a new career high for Noah Dobson. Thanks so much, Mike. Now let's head down to D.C. where the Kraken put their 7-game win streak on the line against the Caps.
TJ back in action, returning after 11-game absence. He's going to help on that right flank tonight.
That's Jaretti. Dylan Strome to the slot. Edmondson, Ovechkin, what a stop! Joey DeCord comes across. He'll get a cover.
How about the passing play there by the Caps? A 3-on-2. Look at Joey read that play. Anthony Mantha off the skate of McMichael. Fanned on, and now a turnover. McMichael stopped by DeCord a couple of times in tight.
And the puck was batted down with a high stick.
It's going to be on the highlight reels tonight throughout the National Hockey League. And if it isn't, there should be an investigation.
Jared McCann through the middle to the outside. Cartier, his shot scores! Ty Cartier! 11:10 left to go in the opening period. The Kraken off and running.
You talk about a beautiful release. Pull it in, shoot it back the other way. 1-0 lead for the Kraken.
Wennberg through center with a shot. They score! Alexander Wennberg. He'll keep his ball rolling right along. And Seattle with a 2-0 lead.
Through the middle, using speed, and right here, pulls it in, is able to snap that one pass.
And a great first period for Seattle.
Ovechkin down the flank, feeds it through. Beautiful pass. Score! Max Pacioretty off of a great relay from Dylan Strome.
Wherever he has played, he's got a deadly release. Beautiful pass off the wing. And there it is, 5-hole on the play. There's the puck, the keepsake given to the training staff.
Beautiful work there.
Washington gaining a little bit of traction. Johnny Gord, they score! Justin Schultz on the follow-up. 1:40 left to go in the second period. A little goal-mouth scramble. Seattle by 2.
But look at Schultz stay with it right on the backhand. Move the puck, move yourself. That's what Schultz did.
Now it's carried out by Larson. Moved along for Tanev. Larson right in. What a goal! Hey, hey, what do you say? Big Cat Adam Larson with a thing of beauty. 4-1 Seattle.
Forehand, backhand. Oh, what a sweet play there by Lars. Just a beautiful play all the way around.
Total team effort once again. From the goal out, they do it again. Great plays throughout. That's Kraken hockey, baby. They surround Joey DeCord tonight. It's a 4-1 win over the Washington Capitals.
How about the Kraken winning their 8th straight game for the second time in their 3-year franchise history? Unlike earlier in the season, they've been winning games with their defense. They've only allowed 9 total goals during this win streak.
Good shot by Cousins, keeping it low, but the guys in front of the net here have to find that. They got to know that's coming and get themselves ready if it comes up hot like that.
Strong entry from Power. Cousins across, scores! J.J. Paterka. They came with speed. They came in hot, and the Sabres take a 1-0 lead.
Turn the puck over. Covered by Tarasenko. His shot scores!
scores. Point number 600 in the NHL for Vladimir Tarasenko is a big goal for Ottawa.
Lukanen doesn't get a clear sight of this at all. Watch the angle right here. Tarasenko throw it towards the net. There's the physical battle. He guesses and goes glove side. It ends up going blocker side. Tarasenko gets it down to the front of the net.
And now the Sabres away with it. Benson one-hands it on, and Forsberg looks shaken up. Oh, Anton Forsberg made the big stop, and he's down. Forsberg, this is difficult to even move, and not what the Sens want to see.
Pushes off, he hits the post there, and then tries to push off, and he can't do it.
Scorpisalo is going to be pressed into duty here late in that first period.
Sabres come to center ice. Tage Thompson carries it. Scores! Tage Thompson shot that puck with an attitude, and it listened as it hums to the back of the net. Sabres take a 2-1 lead.
Sabres go to the power play here for the second time.
Tage Thompson over at the left circle. 29 seconds to go. Scores! Back-to-back darts by TNT, and Tage Thompson has given Buffalo a 3-1 lead. Now here's Krebs, 2-on-1. Krebs pass across, gets it back, scores! Peyton Krebs gives the Sabres a 4-1 lead.
Here comes Greg, moving with Giroux, drops back to Chuck. Across to towards Giroux, that's blocked. Greg follows up, and Giroux scores. Stay with it, Claude Giroux buries to start the third period.
And the Sens have life here.
Down low to Greg from his knees, trying to pull it through stick. Giroux hammers that, scores! What a blast from Claude Giroux, who's pulling his team back into the fight. 6-on-5 for the Senators.
And Dylan Cousins, he's got an empty net. Dylan Cousins scores! The Sabres will have 4 wins in their last 6 games.
Coming up, the Blues shook up their power play units on Thursday and immediately saw some positive results. Jordan Kyrou and company needed it against the Blue Shirts.
Rangers come here with a 2-game losing streak. Haven't lost more than 2 in a row this season, so they're looking to bounce back.
Good job keeping the old zone. Shot by Fox, a save. Fox shot, rebound, save. And they score! Rangers kept going, and Adam Fox in deep puts it home, and the Rangers grab an early lead.
Here it is again. Fox takes a shot. Goodrow one more time, and then just the turnaround, wraparound by Fox, who went to the net. And Rangers a 1-0 lead.
And now Thomas walks in for St. Louis. Robert Thomas waiting for Kyrou. Shoots. He scores! Kyrou shot it this time, and he ties the game at 1.
Jordan Kyrou gets the Blues on the board here, tying it up 1-1 with it. Just a tremendous shot.
Blues power play. Kyrou in. Now to Thomas. Right in. Tip. Kyrou scores! What passing there! And a power play goal makes it 2-1. Kyrou again.
Jordan Kyrou. Backdoor tap in.
Underway here in the second period.
Blues get scored on early, but now up 2-1.
Kyrou had 4 shots on goal. Winds it around to Thomas. Back to Kyrou. Great save. Oh, man.
Brilliant pass. And what a save by Shesterkin.
Now Buchnevich. Pass in front. Save. Oh, another great save. Shesterkin with 2 beauties back to back on Jordan Kyrou.
So the Blues back in the power play. And now Shen knocks it down. Shoots it right on goal. And a save, another shot, they score! Saad into the top corner, a power play goal, it's 3-1.
We talk about this power play being a big deal for the Blues, and Brandon Saad finds the back of the net.
Blues lead it 3-1.
Pass in front, and by everybody, and Kyrou's got a clear-cut breakaway. He's got 2 tonight, for the third, he scores!
His third career hat trick. Kyrou slows down, changes the angle, and then zips this right underneath the glove above the pad. That's just a goal scorer's goal.
And the Blues lead 4-1.
And the Rangers get a power play. Panarin toward the net, looking for deflection. And shot score! Vincent Trocheck, it's a power play goal! And the Rangers cut the Blues lead to 4-2. Shesterkin to the bench, Rangers net is empty.
The center for Buchnevich for the empty net, and he scores! Against his old club, and that'll do it!
Okay, back again with Mike Kelly, and Mike, Blues fans can thank a pair of Jordans for this win. Let's start with the Kyrou hat trick. What'd you see there?
Oh, he could have had four or five. Jordan Kyrou was a man possessed in this game. He was outstanding. He had a lot of really good looks. And St. Louis has had trouble scoring goals recently. We know the power play struggles that they've had. They mixed that up a little bit. They mixed the lines up a little bit. But Kyrou put everybody on his back offensively in this game. Really, really, really strong game from him. And like I said, the Blues kind of needed a bit of an offensive outburst here. As for Jordan Binnington, I mean, man, 40-plus shots. This guy was really good in this game, and a lot of really quality shots from the New York Rangers as well. We know the Rangers have high-end offensive talent. This was not an easy night for Binnington. He was outstanding. So easily the Jordan for the best players for the St. Louis Blues. You take a look at what Binnington had to face in this game. The shots, the slot shots were 22-8 for the Rangers. Cycle chances, they were in St. Louis's zone for a majority of the game, certainly a 5-on-5 as well. Big time game for the Jordans and something for the Blues to build on, because it certainly wasn't perfect.
No doubt about that. Thanks so much, Mike. Let's now head to Winnipeg, where the Jets were looking to win their eighth in a row.
Winnipeg looks for an eighth straight victory. That would be a franchise record. That's deflected off the defenseman Zaitsev. He got it back. Dylan fires. Tip in front as Niederreiter went stumbling and falling into the net. Mrazek pinning him in there.
And Niederreiter going to those dirty areas. Mrazek wants to keep him there. Safer in behind him than out in front.
And Gabe Vilardi right down the slot. Mrazek with a beautiful save.
Unbelievable glove save.
As time will run out of this first period of play.
A little exclamation on a scoreless first period.
No, Mark Scheifele as we look down at the Jets bench right now for whatever reason.
We don't know what this is other than a low body. He's uncomfortable. He leaves the ice and won't return tonight with a lower body injury.
Reichel after it. Reichel leaves it for Murphy. Murphy shoots and scores! Connor Murphy gets the Hawks on the board. 1-0.
Beautiful goal by Connor Murphy. You'd love to see the defense stepping up there.
And a good play defensively. Kachuk edged him off the puck. Centering pass, and Schmidt broke it up with a sliding play.
What a smart play from Nate.
And the shots are 16 apiece after 40 minutes of play. Of course, Chicago's up by a goal.
And Dylan gave it away. Kershaw turns it back. Pitlick had a crowd in front, sent it through, and a fine save. Nice read by Brossoise. He denies Vlasic. Jets power play. They need it. One goal to tie. Perfetti to Domestikov. Niederreiter in front. Cole Perfetti looking to make the pass. Loose it from Niederreiter. That is blocked.
And Mrazek has really factored in, hasn't he? Making unbelievable saves.
Perfetti. Domestikov. Big save. Mrazek again. Morrissey up near the blue line now. Turned it back. Lowry bracing for the check. He accepted it. Centering pass. One.
Vilardi's able to solve Mrazek finally on the 27th shot of this game. 3.5 minutes remains.
Redirected nicely to the stick of Nikolai Ehlers. And he comes, Ehlers shoots it. Score! Nikolai Ehlers! And the Jets have their first lead.
I think that tells you why his nickname is Fly. He's got a vapor trail behind him. He snipes this one past Mrazek. 1:05 remain, and it is shaken.
The Jets have won 8 in a row. They beat the Hawks 2-1. And it took a long time, but they saved their best for last.
The Jets have officially made history with the victory over the Blackhawks. They extend their win streak to 8 straight games, which sets a new franchise record. With the win, they remain at the top of the NHL and are the first team to reach 60 points. Coming up, who doesn't love a good dad's trip? The Flames certainly do. Calgary gave their pops plenty to cheer for on Thursday in the desert. Those highlights next.
Dorofeev on McAvoy's side. A one-timer and a rebound, a save, a couple of them by Swayman.
That Eichel's shaking up.
He'll get a little help here from Barbashev. A free ride. Everybody will get a hand in it to get him back to the bench. There's a look at Jack Eichel. Would not look good as he's helped back down to the Golden Knights room.
Well, a couple of minutes ago was a skate problem. That did not look like a skate problem.
Here's a look at the play. As much as he tries to get along the boards, that left leg gets caught.
And Jack Eichel, who left the game injured earlier in this period, Marshawn into the offensive end, rolls up, stop play, and now, holy smokes, Mark Stone wincing as he heads to the bench.
Wow, when it rains, it pours, and Stone right back. A little bit of glue, Harry Cunn, an inadvertent elbow from Geeky as he goes in the corner to play the puck. You see his left arm comes up and catches Marsh, so up that right high area, right under the visor. Good to see Jonathan Marsh, so said. That elbow. He's back on the ice. Eichel back. So some good signs here towards the end of the second period for the Golden Knights.
No score through two now. The more good news for the Golden Knights. The captain Mark Stone returning to begin the third. A fifth power play for the Golden Knights. Fifth penalty on Boston. Stone gloving it down. Feeds it off to Barbashev. Tack pass to Martinez. Marchessault set it attack. Score! Jack Eichel on the doorstep on the power play. And the Golden Knights break the ice.
Just enough to put it between the pads of Swayman.
Cotter almost lost it. Then loads it to Thompson, bailed him out. But a big save on Geeky. Logan Thompson, one of his best of the night.
Frederick keeps it in. Grizzlick scores! Matt Grizzlick with his first goal in 20 games. Petrangelo, a cannon shot, and Barbashev. Swayman with a heroic block.
We'll head to overtime, cutting through center ice. Into the zone with Petrangelo. Stone looking to Petrangelo, and he scores! Alex Petrangelo, second of the season from Mark Stone. It's a 2-1 overtime win.
Oh, what a game, and maybe the guy that needed that. First and 27 for Alex Petrangelo, and it's a big one. He saved it for the right moment, and a huge win here for the Golden Knights.
Alex Petrangelo was the hero as he grabbed just his second goal of the season and first since November 10th, snapping a 26-game goalless drought. His third overtime goal in a Vegas uniform is already the same amount that he had in 12 seasons with the Blues.
This overtime game winner is powered by the long-lasting power of Energizer. Still going.
We saw Michael Backlund tie Mark Giordano for second all-time games played in the organization. That was 949. Tonight, it's number 950 to take sole possession of number two overall in the games played list.
Here's Keller. Pass picked off. Pullman with Backlund breaking through. There's the pass. Backlund all alone. Right in. Michael Backlund, 20 seconds in, and the Flames take a 1-0 lead. So Backlund in his 950th game. Dad's happy about that one. Worked in by Zucker. He's back in the lineup after serving a three-game suspension with the Flames steal. Carried in by Pullman. Nice pass, Sharangovich. In front, scores on the backhand. Short-handed goal. What a move by Sharangovich to make it 2-0 Calgary. Wow.
Now this is special.
That's worth dancing about.
Oh, this is special.
Back to Weegar. Blocks the line. Finds Kadri. Shoots. Just wide. Bounces in front. They score. Anderson tucks it in. Three first period goals for the Flames.
Dad's better stay here all year. What a start. Fourth line did not have a good shift for the Flames. That sort of set the momentum going the other way. And then it's
in the net. Score. Tipped in front by Coleman. What a first period for him. And the Flames answer back seconds later and restore a three-goal lead.
Tried to flip it back to center. Picked up. Here's an opportunity. Keller with it.
Keller shoots. He scores! Clayton Keller! And the lead has been cut in half.
Broken up by Lindholm. Muscles of the head. Here's a two-on-one. Huberto with Sharangovich. Sharangovich scores! Second of the game for Sharangovich on a setup by Huberto, and the Flames restore their three-goal lead.
What a pass, and oh my goodness, Sharangovich with the release.
His power play looks dangerous right now. Huberto from the half-board. Weegar, Huberto again. Makes a move, passing now Lopez in front, they score, hat-trick goal! Yegor Sharangovich on the power play! Man advantage finally pays off.
Beautiful passing play, and this power play is getting special.
So the Flames are winners of back-to-back games thanks to Yegor Sharangovich's five goals in that span, including a hat-trick on Thursday. He can become the first Flame in franchise history with multiple goals in three straight games when they take on the Golden Knights on Saturday.
Ruda, who's partnered with Henry Trott on defense, and they score! Luke Cunningham and the Sharks on the board. They lead it 1-0.
Good
forecheck by Bailey creates the turnover, and a fortuitous little bounce there as it enters right out into the slot and puts it in the back of the net.
Now Hurdle runs into Matheson, and Hurdle with the puck behind the Montreal net. Zetterlund scores! Fabian Zetterlund and the Sharks with two here in the first period.
Savard again, Matheson in front, Gallagher shoots, score! Has .200 in his National Hockey League career.
Now McKyle skates through traffic behind the net, has some open ice. Nice little pick run as well. A hot shoot, he scores! His first goal as a San Jose Shark for Nikita. A hot shoot, and it's 3-1.
Well, McKyle Granlund, 23 assists on the season. Waits for that seam to open up right there. And there's Ochuk sliding down from the point and finds a little sliver of an opportunity there on the short side underneath the arm.
With Montembeau on the bench now for the extra attacker.
Suzuki for Caulfield. Caulfield, Matheson shoots, score! Mike Matheson with the rocket! And Montreal within one. On bobblehead night, Anderson the deflection. Don't go anywhere, we're not done yet.
Now to a dozen seconds left. Matheson, and that's saved by Blackwood. Again, blocked by Zetterlund. Granlund sends it down the ice. It'll make its way over the goal line, and the game is over.
And the Sharks end their losing streak, and Mackenzie Blackwood with his first road win of the season. And that is a collective sigh of relief here in Montreal and all through Sharks territory.
Six, count them, six overtime game winners around the National on Thursday. We'll relive the best the NHL has to offer, including historic winning streaks.
Bandai, now a turnover. McMichael, stopped by Decor. A couple of times in tight.
Wonderful stop by Decor.
The Canucks a fourth straight road win.
Pulls it back, still with it, gets it around it. His shot, score! Darren Radek with a lightning strike. Bolts win it.
Here's Ryan Hart on the doorstep on the back. He scores! Let's go home, baby! Sam Reinhardt extends the winning streak.
Well, that's out there for the faceoff. One back to Thompson. Thompson for Barzell.
Well, break out the record books. For the first time in NHL history, there are four teams with simultaneous winning streaks of at least eight games as the Panthers, Oilers, Jets, and Kraken all earned victories. They will all be back in action on Saturday night, looking to keep their streaks alive. Winning streaks weren't the only big theme of the night. We saw six different overtime game winners tied for the single-day NHL record. Congrats to Darnell Nurse, Sam Reinhardt, Elias Pettersson, Darren Radish, Matthew Barzell, and Alex Pietrangelo for making history. And before we go, some great news out of Colorado. Avalanche captain Gabriel Landeskog skated for the first time since undergoing a cartilage transplant in his right knee. Landeskog last played on June 26, 2022, the night the Avs raised their third Stanley Cup in franchise history. And that does it for us here at On the Fly. I'm Steve Gelbs. Thanks for watching.